SHOT Show, and it's snowing. I don't have the time to wait on this. We gotta do something about this. Surprised because of the way you came up with it, but nobody has ever done air. But explain to people watching right now why you're doing air. Where did the genesis of this come from?
It came from a helmet bag, very, very expensive, from $100,000 to $200,000 a piece, all the way up to $500,000 a piece. And you had to make a decision. You either make your case flimsy, but something you can store in the cockpit and non-protective, or you make it very heavy and not collapsible, and something that you can't get in the cockpit.
Right.
So I knew there had to be a way that you could do both. You could be both very protective, but also collapsible and storable. Add in lightweight and some other features, and you've got what we come up with here today.
Now, the helmet he was protecting, helmets in today's jet aircraft are actually part of the plane. They're part of the control system and everything else.
Yes,
so it was very important that you maintain that. Were you financially responsible for those two?
No.
Okay. That's good. That's good anyway.
Twice as much as my house.
So Air Armor Tech, this is the full size case?
This is the mid-length.
This is the mid-length case. I have one of these that I haven't. This is what it looks like when it's not inflated. This is what it looks like when it is inflated. Can we open that up and take a good look at everything inside of it?
All right, so inside, first of all, you can see the bladder. It's going to be protecting all your weapons, and it's air, so it conforms to your weapon. For this case, single gun, but we actually almost always fit two guns in here, because once you put it together, it's very solid to hold your weapons. It's got a barrel sleeve down there. You've got Velcro straps to keep it in place. And then it's got a reinforced muzzle pocket, so that if you were to drop it on the end, it's not going to come flying out the end of your case center. It's got a what we use is a pistol pouch here. You've got a mag pocket with some molly to attach some other accessories. And then you got a barrel sleeve if you have extra barrels.
Got some loop?
Yep. Got some loop here, for patches or whatever. And then laid out, it's solid. So, most of our customers use this also as a shooting mag.
And then once you're done. Get to this piece, which you can use in conjunction with this one.
Yes. Yeah, so that's a scope cover down there, and what guys will do is they'll, either deflate or semi-deflate the scope cover, and then they can put this on, in the case as well. But this is for going to, very austere environments. Once you get out of transportation, get out of the truck and start moving, or strap it to your ATV, strap it to your four-wheeler, put it on your back. You can take it pretty much anywhere. And this scope cover right here, by the way, floats 21 pounds.
Also, in a pinch, you could pop these ends up and use it without taking the scope cover off.
That's exactly right. So you don't have to take it off. You can blast through it. You can take an AR type of weapon. You can shoot with the scope cover on. Bolt weapon, you're going to have to take it off, which is an easy process. So, and it's off.
When you're using this as your shooting mat that you're laying on, you can use this as your gun support, buckle it back up, stick it out front,
Yeah.
So.
That's got to remember for you.
Exactly. Yeah. So you can also use it as a sandbag, but obviously without.
Sand.
Yeah, without the weight of sand. So other uses, we have guys who will stick actually the barrel through the weapon, and then they can rest it on things. They don't worry about, messing
up. You can use that for trauma care with a broken arm.
That's what our spec ops guys are like. Hey, can you use it as a splint? And I think with the right imagination, you can use it just about everything. So our precision rifle guys that are, use it as a rear gun bag. And then last but not least, among other things, you can use it as a seat to keep your butt off the cold or hot ground. So very versatile, and it's limited by your imagination, really. But its primary function is to protect that optic, both the investment that you made in it, and sometimes more importantly, the zero that you took the time to make sure your weapon was zeroed in. When you get to that shot, whether it's a human, in a military or law enforcement scenario, or an animal that you trapped and you paid a lot of money to hunt, you're going to make sure that your zero's on, regardless of what you do to it.
Now, this also comes with straps on the back, so you carry it like a backpack?
Yes, sir. So it starts off, it's already lightweight, but it's got some really good backpack straps in it, so you can take those, deploy those, and carry it on your back, then your hands-free carry, where you can carry ammo boxes or, whatever luggage, whatever it is you carry.
Carry your rifle with you. With your protective bag over the top of that.
Yes, sir.
This is going to be my ISIS welcome wagon bag when we get it all fully constituted. Got the weapon for it, got the handgun for it, got all the other stuff for it. Air Armor Tech, for those of you who make an investment, I mean, a rifle like this is an investment. This is not something that you're just, buying on the weekend. There's a lot of thought that goes into this. There's a lot of thought that goes into your glass. This is the barrier, the bag, the protective system to carry it around in. And well worth the time and the versatility of it, of all the pieces involved in it. You even sell the pumps to go with it, right? And all the adapters to make sure you pump it up.
Yes.
How many pounds of air does it take to fill it up?
Well, so this bag you can blow up. It's got a high volume inflation, so you can pump it up with your lungs, 7 to 10 breaths, so it's not like a full flow. You can use a compressor if you've got the source of compressed air. And it also comes with pumps. I don't have one here, but any type of bicycle
pump. I've got
pump
one. I'll show it to you later.
Or needle pump, you can pump it up with that. And, some people, we've had some people come up here at SHOT Show and say, I kept seeing those things, and I thought it was the clear plastic that you put in a shipping box. And, how tough could that be? Like he didn't think they were going to be tough. But we've actually put a weapon in this and driven a Humvee over it 10 or 12 times. The Humvee weighed 10,000 pounds. We dropped it 1,000 feet out of a helicopter, and it bounced 15 feet in the air. Both those scenarios had a weapon in it. When we dropped it in the helicopter, it was $6,000 Nemo arms in it. So we're putting our money where our mouth is, and they're tough.
When I do my test, I'm just going to drive a Ford Escape over it. Domestic? Yes, we do. One last thing, the air bladders in them, if they do go?
Right. So, fortunately, we haven't had a single failure yet, so we're proud of that, but it's probably inevitable. We include with the case a simple terrain patch. So it's a 200 denier nylon with urethane coating in it, and it's as simple as taking the little sticker mic. Rubbing the air bubbles out, and you're good to go.
You can't overinflate it and make it go bad because it has a pressure release valve, overinflation valve. So, very well thought out. This came from the G suit. The idea came from the G suit. You cut up one of your. What do they say when you cut up one of your G suits? Was that an issue? Or did they let you take that home?
Well, fortunately, when I was in the Navy, they gave me my gear when I left.
Okay.
I wanted to keep it for posterity, maybe turn it over to my son, but.
Then you cut it up.
I had to cut it up. I had to figure out what it was inside.
You can just take one of these, put some sleeves on it, and then wear
one.
You can do that. Blaine Tompkins, airarmortech.com. Go check them out. You're going to see more of this stuff because this is now an integrated part of my kit. You'll be hearing them on Lock and Load on a regular basis. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Appreciate the opportunity.
airarmortech.com.